Good morning, friends. Today I have come up with another figure of speech, blank verse. I'm sure you must have watched my earlier videos and liked them also. Today, blank verse is my topic of lecture. What is a blank verse? Friends, blank verse is a poetry written with regular, metrical, but unrhymed lines and always in iambic pentameter. It has been described as probably the most common and influential form that English poetry has taken since the 16th century, and Paul Fussell has estimated that about 3/4 of all English poetry is in blank verse. Blank verse is also the preeminent dramatic and narrative form in English, and also the standard form of dramatic verse in Italian and German. Now, of all the verse forms, blank verse is the closest to the natural rhythms of the English language, English speech, yet the most flexible and adaptive to the diverse levels of discourse. As a result, it has been frequently and variously used than any other type. Now, this blank verse in poetry and prose has a consistent meter with 10 syllables in each line, which is known as pentameter, where the unstressed syllables are followed by the stressed ones, 5 of which are stressed, but even the stressed syllables do not rhyme. And so, blank verse is also known as unrhymed iambic pentameter. The first known use of blank verse in English language was by Henry Howard, the Earl of Surrey, in his translation of Aeneid, which was composed in 1540 and published posthumously between 1554 and 1557. He must have been inspired. Or why did he write so? Why did he use this form? I think he must have been inspired by the Latin original, as the classic Latin verse did not use rhyme or meter. He was inspired by the ancient Greek verse, or the Italian form of verse, of versi scriptae, both of which did not rhyme. The best and notable example of end-stopped blank verse is the play Arden of Feversham. A free form of blank verse was the medium of many other later plays, even after Henry Howard, as those of Maxwell Anderson and T.S. Eliot. Milton used blank verse for his epic poems. James Thomson used it for his descriptive and philosophical works, Seasons, that was published in 1726 and between 1713. Wordsworth used it for his autobiographical Prelude. Tennyson used it for the narrative Ideal of the King. Browning for The Ring and the Book, and many other dramatic monologues, and T.S. Eliot for much of the Westland. Many meditative lyrics have also been written in blank verse, including Coleridge's Frost at Midnight, Wordsworth's Tintinnabe, Tennyson's Tears, Idle Tears, and Wallace Stevens' Sunday Morning. Now, the formal divisions in blank verse poems setting off each sustained unit of meaning are called verse paragraphs. That was all for blank verse. To put it in a nutshell or in a crux, we can name four main features of the blank verse. In the first place, we have blank verse. Poetry has no fixed number of lines. In the second place, it has a conventional meter that is used for verse drama and long narrative poems. In the third place, it is often used in descriptive and reflective poems and dramatic monologues too. The poems in which a single character delivers his thoughts in the form of a speech. And last but not the least, blank verse can be composed in any kind of meter, such as iamb, spondee, trochee, or tactile. That was all about blank verse and its use in poetry. Thank you.